It is a place where some of the sharpest minds share insight about science. The World Science Forum gives people a rare chance to ask questions and learn about the latest scientific challenges and developments. Shiki Latsi from Hungary's Mowi TV reports on this year's theme.
Knowledge and future. These were the themes of the 4th World Science Forum Budapest. Almost 800 scientists, politicians and science journalists gathered at the Hungarian Academy of Sciences in November to discuss where today's science is heading. In his speech at the Hungarian Parliament, Egyptian chemist and Nobel laureate Ahmed Zewail came to the conclusion that despite of today's amazing scientific achievements, the still existing phenomena of famine, poverty and the rapid ecological degradation are all rooted in two major causes.
One is the lack of knowledge or ignorance. And two is the lack of resources. And unless we do something about these in a global way, we're going to always be living in conflicts in a major way.
While old attitudes failed to yield viable solutions in providing decent living standards for as much as 80% of the world's population, something must be done very differently in the future. But exactly what and how? Nobody really knows yet. World Science Forum participants agree. Radically improved communication is an essential step forward in these complex issues.
It's critically important that the scientific community be engaged with the rest of society. And the only way to do that is in a real dialogue where the public comes to understand science, but science comes to understand the public.
It's not a subtle, deep psychology you need. It is just a matter of understanding your audience and relating to them.
Furthermore, society must constantly be assured that scientists keep in mind, while they are digging in for subatomic particles, developing new vaccines, or reaching for distant galaxies, they do it for one single reason, for the benefit of humankind.
Science should offer not only its results, but also its stringent ethics to the society. And science should show an example of trustworthiness.
As for using the available resources more efficiently in the future, science should also find ways to help politicians to appropriately coordinate their efforts.
I don't feel that the other specialized agencies are working in tandem with UNESCO. You know, we have UNICEF, we have UNHCR, we have UNEP, and they work with us when it's necessary, but when it's not, then they do their own thing. I feel we should always, always be on the same page.
The next major test to see if scientists and politicians are on the same page will be at the upcoming Copenhagen Climate Conference. Shiki Laci for CNN Worldview from Mowi TV Budapest.